Yeah, well, I'm David Worth. I'm from Science and Technology Facilities Council, and you'll see a couple of other people from the same council later on. I'm coming at this as probably a traditional computational scientist. I have a PhD in mathematics, which basically meant I wrote code to do some modelling work. And obviously, because I knew nothing, the code was rubbish. I didn't know anything about software engineering as a PhD student. And so I did my best, and the results kind of looked okay when compared with the experiments and other mathematical models. And my supervisor said that, oh yeah, the results looked really good. So I was happy and papers were published. When I finished my PhD and then moved, I found myself with on-the-job training in simple things like coverage testing, performance evaluation, and then into object orientation, supporting languages like C++, IDEs, and all the whole of that kind of thing. None of it is particularly modern. None of it is particularly full of the latest jargon for software development. But in the software engineering support program, I kind of feel it's ideal. This CESP program has been set up to introduce modern software engineering methods, and by modern we perhaps don't mean ultra modern. We tend not to use a lot of jargon because that just turns computational scientists, PhD students off. They just don't want to know, and supervisors think no, it's all a load of airy fairy, pie in the sky nonsense, which won't contribute anything to my research. So we're looking at tools. Can they be applied in this kind of the traditional computational science? So that looking at Fortran languages, Fortran code. A lot of it, very old, developed in the 70s, and it's still going now because it's useful, because people have done good research with it, and they want to keep on going. They want to develop it and add more modules to it. So we're sort of helping them, how do you get the code that is old into a state where it's easy to modify, easy to keep going, is of good quality. Talking to them about testing, which Judith said was kind of a complete anathema to most of them. But if we're trying to introduce things like the coverage testing and so on, we're always looking at pragmatic tools. It's not the latest and greatest. It is what can help people do their research. We're investigating tools, new kind of things. We're not averse ourselves to looking at tools, looking at agile methodologies, pair programming, that kind of thing, test-driven development. I mean, some of the work we do for ourselves in other projects, we've actually used it. And obviously by doing that, we get an idea of, can it be applied in the more traditional setting? And then we're into dissemination and training. We've done a lot of training with our own computational science department, again, Fortran code testing and so on. And we're also hooking up with CCPs, so that's collaborative computational projects, again, kind of traditional computational science, but trying to give them some training on how to improve the quality of their software and get it ready for the next generation of programmers. And all the time we seem to be coming back to this sustainability means looking at the quality of your software. Is it easy to understand? Is it well documented? Is testing easy? Is it well tested at the moment? Could that be improved? How's performance is important in a lot of these codes. But all the time it's pragmatic. And then just in my last half minute, CCPForge, which I guess fits in better here, is all about collaboration. It includes a whole load of stuff which is listed there to help collaboration, revision control, tracking. If you've got a computational science project and you want these kind of things, then go along to the website. There's a poster downstairs where website is, and there's lots more details on there, and there's a poster on CESP as well. And then just send me an email and I'll help you get started.
Thank you.